I was at the station when the call came in. I walked in the communications room and one of the guys on the desk said that he had taken a call from a woman saying that her son had taken her car without her permission and she wanted him arrested. I left the station, went up the road maybe a mile, sat in a U-turn, and within 2 minutes the vehicle went past me. I activated my overhead lights and the vehicle continued driving for about a mile, mile and a half. He went from the right-hand shoulder across three lanes and drove through the median. I went about 300-400 feet up the road, went through a U-turn and lost sight of him. I continued southbound and only one vehicle went eastbound, so that was the vehicle I went after. When I caught up with it, it was smoking and I could tell that it was disabled. He just kind of came to a stop and then started rolling backwards towards my troop car. He kicked the door open a couple of times and I thought he was going to run, so I thought it was going to be a foot pursuit. I reached over to grab my flashlight and I heard a loud bang. And as I was looking to my left, it looked like a firework hit the hood of my troop car. And I looked at him and realized he was shooting at me. I saw and heard the third shot. I felt glass hit my face. And my first reaction was to duck down and get help coming on the way. As I was laying down on the printer, I yelled shots fired in the radio. When I drew my sidearm and I came up behind the dash, he was approaching the troop car and I could see he was trying to clear the rifle. He had a misfire. He got to the front of my troop car and he knelt down in front of the driver's side headlight. This whole time I was shooting at him through my windshield. I don't know if any of the shots hit him at that point. He stood up. I could see that he must have cleared the stoppage in the rifle. He stood up and started to flank me. And I kicked the door open at the same time as he was standing up. And I went empty. I had to reload. And he shot through the door of the troop car. And I had a good sight picture between the door frame and the window frame. And I could tell that I hit him.
Trooper Conklin, he just really exhibited the best example of a state trooper that I could ever imagine.
I could describe Trooper Conklin in one word: a gentleman. And as a senior trooper, and with his work ethic, the junior troopers really look up to him as a role model, and that's a great asset that we have in our zone to have him.
I spoke to him shortly after the event and told him he was a hero. And he really did the state police proud.